What's up, everybody? Today I have an unboxing video for you today. I know I haven't been making videos in a while, but that's kind of because college started again and I'm taking some hard classes this semester, so plus I have work, so it's kind of hard to ride, make time for riding, school, work, and studying and all that. So I apologize for not making videos as often, but I'm gonna try it. Right now I'm making this unboxing video for you. And I'm also gonna have a new bike check with some riding clips coming soon, like probably a week after this video, after I test out the new parts and stuff. So, and I'll probably have another webisode coming out. See, the thing with my webisodes is my friends are also really busy with school and work, so it's like I don't want to make a webisode with just me in it because that's kind of boring. So I always try to make webisodes with friends. So yeah, I'll talk about that more later. Enough of that. The stuff that I got here today, well, I probably should have put a fisheye on, probably get a fisheye on right now just to see. There we go, that's a lot better. So I got my fisheye on, and pretty much the parts that I got here are some new tires. The reason why I pretty much got the Track Curly tires is because one of my boys, Stefan, who rides for Premium, has these tires, and I seen him ride it, and kind of made me want to try them out, because the color scheme on my bike is black, red, and oil slick. And chrome. So this has like the red sidewall, and they come in size this is the 2.4 version, and I never ever really rode fat tires as this, like I never went 2.4. so plus these are really really light for a really fat tire. These kind of remind excuse me, I just woke up. These kind of remind me of the Demolition Momentum tires in the weight, but I didn't get them just because of the weight. I got them because they kind of look good for the thread. I don't know what's going on with my voice. And they also got the red wall, which looks good. And yeah, that's that. The next thing, big thing that I got is some profile cranks. I know what you're thinking. What? Why new cranks? As you probably know, my new frame, well, not new frame, it's not new to me anymore. Excuse me. I just woke up, got the UPS, and that's why my voice is kind of weird. But the reason why I got new cranks is because my fit and then cranks are size 175, which is pretty long because my back end is really short. So if I wanted to ride four pegs, then I needed to get 165 cranks, because if I put on if I have two pegs in the back, when I pedal, my foot touches, like my heel, it touches the peg. So I just wanted to get size 165, as you can see. I don't know, oh, it doesn't say, oh yeah, 165, that's a 5, and these are the profile GDH cranks, and they come with the crank arm remover tool, which is good. You got your spindle, the other crank arm, and you know, it's always good to go with a company that has lifetime warranty, which is such as Profile, which they do give you lifetime warranty. These cranks feel very light too. And they're really sturdy. A lot of people said good things about them. Can't go wrong with Profile. Over here it says, kind of hard to see, but it says Profile Racing. That's that. The next thing, I forgot to show you what the spindle looks like, if anybody was wondering. It just says Profile GDH. You could fit a, what do you mean? You could fit the Allen key in there, which is, and then you just unscrew it. And as you can see, as the splines here, make sure you guys grease it up, everything up before you put it in your bottom bracket. So that's spindle. This is the left crank, I believe. Yeah, left. And that's the right. As you can see, they're a little bit shorter than your standard 175 cranks that people run. And also, 165 cranks, a lot of pros say that it feels really good, like Jake Seeley and Ty Morrow, I believe. And Ty Morrow, Jake Seeley, and Alex Nanacci, I'm pretty sure they run 165mm cranks, and they say it's really good and much more responsive, and since your feet are closer together, it's just easier to maneuver and stuff. So I'm pretty stoked to try it out and see if I like it. Hopefully I do. But yeah, that's it. That was just a pair of grips in black, because my Devin Smiley grips that I have on my bike right now, they stretched out a lot and they started to rip. But those are some really, really good grips. I highly recommend those. I would get them again, except Dance Comp didn't have them in stock for the color I wanted, black, so I just got the BSD grips, wanted to try these out, the Dan Paley Slims. You know, the grip looks good on these, so if anyone has them, let me know what to expect. I paid a total of $208 for the cranks, tires, and grips. I used the 15% off code, which saves you a lot. And that's pretty much it that I got for today. Just cranks, grips, tires. My old cranks, I'm going to sell them to my friend for pretty cheap. There's nothing wrong with them. They just have a couple scratches. But yeah, I'm stoked to go back to four pegs. I already have a lot of tricks in mind going back to four pegs. That's why I really wanted to go back. And, you know, new tires, everything. So that's it. Please like this video. Follow me on Instagram at flybiker96 because I post daily jibs and whatnot sometimes whenever I go riding. Pics on my bike will be up on my Instagram and stuff like that, so just go check that out. And that's pretty much it for today. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.